Alright guys, it's TechReviewer718 and today we're going to be taking a look at the OtterBox Defender for the iPod Touch 5th generation. So big thank you to OtterBox for actually providing this case free for review. So if you guys are interested in checking this out, please check out OtterBox's website, link in the description. Also their Twitter and Facebook links will be below if you're interested in following them or liking them on Facebook. So there you go. I will also include Amazon's link so you guys can check that out too if you want a better deal. So here we go. Here's the OtterBox Defender for the iPod Touch 5th generation. Now, the reason why I left it inside, I did not assemble it in videos because it's such a pain to put in. So rather than wasting time in the review, we'll just get to the actual case. And before we show you the case, OtterBox does include a lanyard loop, so it has an included insert for it right there. So if you're interested in putting that there, you could do that. You can't really put it on the included Apple one, you just gotta use that one. So there you go. So let's look around the case. They do give you a cutout for the Apple logo. It does have some protection right there. The camera is exposed right there. Everything right here is exposed. There's no plastic or anything to protect that. So just note that. In the bottom right here, we have access to the charging port and the headset port. And your speaker right there is exposed a little bit so you can hear it. And the volume rockers are right there. And they're perfectly clickable. Power button right there. Now, the front does have a lot of protection, and it has a really good lay on the table design, as you've come to know with these cases from OtterBox. It does not feel thick at all. It actually is a very slim case for a Defender, and that's one thing, one of my disappointments with this case. It actually feels really cheap compared to the OtterBox Defender for the iPhone 5. Not the silicone part. The silicone part is actually great. I'm talking about the shell part. It just feels a little too flimsy. Now, I know it'll probably still protect it, but I don't think it will protect it as much as the iPhone 5 Defender. So there you go. You do have access to the camera right there. And there is a built-in screen protector right here, which does not lay completely with the display, so I don't know if you're going to be able to tell on video. I don't know if you can hear that. It does not lay completely in the display, so if you click really, really soft, it's not going to recognize your touch. You got to press really hard. Not really hard, but just with a decent amount of pressure, and you'll activate the screen. So hopefully I'll be able to turn on and give you an idea. See? It just... you gotta just put a little bit more pressure than usual. As you can tell, we haven't actually activated this iPod Touch, but there you go. So again, the screen protector does not bubble. Maybe that's the reason why they decided to go that route. But again, does not touch all the way. And it feels really great in hand. And another thing is, this does sometimes does not go completely in. You gotta really make sure you massage the silicone in really good, because you don't want the case to be unprotected because you didn't put it in all the way. But the actual case itself is pretty good. And again, if you're interested in checking out this case, I highly recommend this case for the iPod Touch. It might be the best case out there for this iPod Touch, because for the iPod Touch 5th generation, which is actually pretty disappointing, there's not that many cases out there for it. So that's actually the big disappointment about it. A lot of companies are not really focusing on this iPod Touch. So I'm glad to see that OtterBox actually did produce a case. So if you're interested in buying this, again, links in the description. And that's it for my review, guys. Comment, like, and subscribe. And that's it. Peace.